Hi friends, welcome to Model Ideas. This channel is to you to guide you, motivate you towards courses and government jobs. I'm going to explain today, that is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University has given notification for M.Phil and Ph.D programs in distance mode for the academic year 2020 and 21. Now, subjects. The Ph.D course is available for from that arts Telugu, Hindi and English. From commerce subject, education also. From social sciences, economics, history, library and information science, political science, public administration and sociology. So there are no subjects from that science background now. Then let me see what is the criteria to go for M.Phil and Ph.D. So let me first discuss M.Phil, eligibility for M.Phil. So same, the courses for that Ph.D and M.Phil are same. Even from that M.Phil, if you want to continue your M.Phil, then there are chances for English, Hindi, Telugu, Commerce, Education, Economics, History, Library and Information, Science, then Political Science, then Public Administration and Sociology. Admission. Then those who have completed their post-graduation with 55% or SCST 50%, then you can apply and write the 10 science examination. And after entrance examination, they can call you for interview. Then the students, those who have completed and those who have qualified NET or SET or maybe SLET, then these students, they need not write entrance examination. Directly by paying registration fee, they can attend for interviews. Now, what is the duration of this course, right? Actually, the minimum period for that M.Phil is at 2 years, but you can extend another 1 year by paying 10,000 rupees. And this is possible without money for women who has taken maternity leaves and childcare leaves, and M.Phil or Ph.D, they can give the chance for only women, and men, they must have to complete that. Or if they did not complete, then every year they need to pay 10,000 rupees. And the complete amount for this year, 10,000 rupees for annum for tuition fees and 3,000 rupees also for that tuition fees. Okay, this is all about that M.Phil. And next, research methodology. There are the two parts. Part one is that coursework and part two is that dissertation. So when you submit dissertation, then they can call you for Viva questions, Viva examination. Then if you qualified in that Viva examination, then after you will be succeeded in your M.Phil. Then let me go for PhDs. Then here also that PhD courses, English, Hindi, Telugu, Commerce, Education, Economics, History, Library and Information Science, Political Science, Public Administration, Sociology. These subjects are available to go for a PhD, but there are no subjects from that science background, Maths, Physics or Chemistry or Botany, Geology from here to that. And here also that even a PG completed student, he can apply for M.Phil or Ph.D or both. Who have completed their PG with 50%, 55% marks or SCST 50% marks, then they can apply for it. And again, who complete their qualified NET or SET or JRF or whatever we've been able that, or even if you complete your M.Phil, so you are exempted from writing this examination. You need not write entrance examination. Directly you can attend interview by paying registration fee. Then PhD, it must be completed within the 3 years, or you can extend it to the 5 years, but you can complete within the 5 years. Otherwise you need to pay 15,000 rupees as penalty for every year, and academic fee is at 15,000 rupees every year and 3,000 rupees, means 18,000 rupees you need to pay for annum. Here also the same coursework, PhD divided into two parts, coursework, that is that a PhD coursework part 1 and part 2, thesis writing. So here the same situation, if you complete your thesis, then you need to submit a dissertation or thesis to the department to your guide, and then immediately they have Viva questions, Viva examination. If you qualify in the Viva examination, and they can award you doctorate, PhD. This is all about that PhD and M.Phil courses. So if you have any doubts, just you can ask me and I will try to give my answers. And it is a very good opportunity for employees and even for students, because for the last some years we don't have any kind of PhD entrance examination in Telangana state. The last is that Usmani University, I think before 2 years. Now it is a good opportunity and it is in the distance mode. So by working any other places, then we can complete as soon as possible, and it's a good opportunity for the students who recently qualified SLET and NET. So just you can go and join in this group and have your doctorate award in front of your name. Thank you all.